Hi everyone, first and foremost, I say this every damn time I do a one take, I cannot see the viewfinder, I cannot look into the viewfinder. People who are totally blind can't do that, and this person who is totally blind doesn't give a damn what the picture looks like. Yeah, first and foremost, if you want sugar-coated, censored language, you might want to reconsider how much you really want to be subscribed to me. I know subscribers are the only way I'm going to be able to get monetized, but I'm not willing to insert emoji with censor symbols on the mouth and tongue here. I'm not willing to do that to myself anymore. I am who I am, and anyone who doesn't like it can kiss me where the sun don't shine. And I'm just not gonna, maybe I should add that to the description. I'm gonna tell it like it is. I'm gonna tell it like I really feel. I'm gonna tell you how I really feel. And if you don't want to hear it, I can understand if you don't want to stay subscribed to me, because I'm just gonna be freaking real here. This is just kind of a one take right now. A filler video for Vlogust probably. You know, I do Starbucks Saturday, but I wonder if I should change it to Sports Bar Saturday. This is the second consecutive week where I have recorded a video from this sports bar I hang out at on the weekends. So, what is it that I'm thinking about tonight? The fact that I was just on YouTube searching for, you know, I mean, I don't know if what I want to do is possible or not, but I searched for what I was looking for. I saw a result that looked like it was what I wanted. I tapped it, or double tapped it, really, because I was using voiceover, and double tapping is synonymous with tapping. And you know what it was? A damn piece of music, probably with a bunch of pictures on it, not a single spoken word. What am I supposed to get out of that? Okay, it's true. I have Ira. In case this is the first time you've watched my videos and or you didn't see the ones where I explained what Ira was. Ira is it's an app that connects me to a human being who is trained to describe things for blind people. There's another app out there called Be My Eyes. And that is not a bad app, but with that you're getting the random stranger who really is just doing what they know to do. With Ira, they put their agents through a lot of training before they let them loose on the app. So it's true, I do have Ira, but number one, I can't call Ira without using my iPhone at the moment. They have newer, later, greater technology that not only allows you to call from outside of your iPhone, but I expect that device to work better. I can't freaking wait for that to come. I'm set to get a set of these things, but they haven't been shipped out yet. Anyway, the point is, I can't watch YouTube and then on the same iPhone get an Ira agent on the phone and say, what is on the screen, since this person who set this video up didn't put a damn solitary spoken word in here. Or if I can, I'm not aware of how to do it. That's number one. Number two, as much as I love Ira, must I call them to describe everything under the sun? This is why I hate it when people put stuff on Twitter to... When people put stuff on Twitter and either the caption doesn't sufficiently say what the picture says, or there is no caption. Because when I open that, all voiceover, which is the setting on the iPhone that when you turn it on, reads the screen out loud, a must-have for someone who can't see. All voiceover knows how to say is image. They can't describe that. I guess that's another point of this channel. To educate people who can't see that, number one, there's a lot of us who can't. Number two, what you can see with your eyes is not freaking everything. I've said that before, I'll say it again. I'll probably say it until the day I die. Because it is not all about what you see. Especially when you're dealing with a blind person, it's about what you can hear. It's only about what you can hear. And I don't care what the title says of the video. If all it is a bunch of music, it's useless to a person like me. So I will not be getting anything out of that video, apparently. Like I said, what I would like to do, I don't know if it's even possible, but I'll probably just call Ira and say, do you know if it's possible to do this? Can you like search and see how we can do it if you can? I mean, Ira's gonna have to help me do it anyway, probably, so. I suppose they might as well research it and help me, or help me research it and we figure out together how to do it. Or it's possible that the only way you can do what I want to do is what I've already done, and it's just not possible to do it the way I want to do it. Anyway, really, people, please. Don't live in your own visual world so much that you can't comprehend that there's... I have to go back to the American Foundation of the Blind website and find out what that statistic is again. I do believe it says millions of people in the world who are blind and can't see what your little visual perfection is. Sorry if all I seem to do is gripe, but it's just, like I said, I'm being real, I'm being the real me. I'm not just the real AMB87 on Twitter, I'm the real AMB87 who has spent a long time trying to really accept the fact that it was okay to be who she was. And if anyone thinks otherwise, then sorry, not sorry. I'm not gonna live my life trying to please you. Anyway, thanks for sitting through this. Everyone's entitled to our own opinion. If you don't agree with me, you have a right to not agree with me, but I have a right to feel the way I do, so. Thanks for watching. Please sign the Do Not Demonetize petition if you feel so moved, and I'll see you tomorrow for the next video. Bye.